He has been a dominant force in this game. Here's Clifford sending away Jeff Carter in. Carter scores up high. It came up quickly, but under the bar and in. And Jeff Carter has the icebreaker here at Rexall.
This is a clean break for Jeff Carter. Blue line in. And it starts with a turnover here at the offensive blue line. Schultz doesn't get it over Clifford's stick. And a nice move. Hard pull in the backhand. Taking it nice and wide. You see the amount of width in that move, getting it up right under the bar from Jeff Carter.
The Kings wanted him to call the Stanley Cup winning moment, and he did that. They kept it for posterity. It is made available to Kings fans in a special DVD. I just think that's a class move by the Kings to make sure Bob was involved in that. And I stepped on you again, Matt McConnell, and a big goal.
That's okay. Jeff Carter, that's not okay. He makes it 3-1.
Just an innocent shot. Big, juicy rebound by Jason LaBarbera off that right pad. Comes to Carter. Got a wide open net. There's the shot. There's the rebound. Nobody picks him up. It's a 3-1 game.
Carter gets the put back at 11:33. The Kings are just one goal shy of equaling their season total heading into tonight.
Carter, Richards, Gagne up front for the Kings, and here's Richards to Carter. Score! On the power play! The Kings' first power play goal of the year in 26 chances. And they are back in the game, but still trailing 2-1.
When the power play's not working, everyone, including myself, we try to diagram things and take a look at strategy and tactics. Well, this one here is just a broken play. Face-off won by the Vancouver Canucks. But you see, the pressure of Gagne creates a loose puck. One miss, second try. It's the second try, so there's nothing fancy about this one. It's just about following plays up. And Jeff Carter's right there. You see Luongo gets a piece, but it goes 7-hole. A spark for the Kings to get it going. They're back within one.
In the corner. Kings still with a man advantage for the first time tonight. First power play of the game. Then a shot and a save and a rebound in front. Score! Tipped in. Scramble in front of the net. Jeff Carter, did he get his stick on it? Either way, the Kings have taken a 2-1 lead. It comes on a power play goal.
And it starts with an innocent-looking shot by Dustin Brown. It looked like Brown just says, you know what, nothing's been working here. I'm going to take the shot and make something happen. Now, Carter will get his stick on it from behind the net. Does it hit anyone else? Does it hit Kopitar or does it hit a defender? If it doesn't hit Kopitar, of course, Carter would get the goal. It's off the skate. So Jeff Carter will get the goal, and Bob, wait till the announcement. They're not going to be happy here,
no.
But again, it's an innocent-looking play. You got big bodies, you got Kopitar, you got Carter, and Dustin Brown, he took charge. He said, I've got time, I'm going to shoot it, look for a second chance, and the Kings lead 2-1.
Daryl Sutter was asked this morning, does it have anything to do with Jonathan Quick's back? Not the case.
Kings come back, Carter driving to the net, in front, he scores! Jeff Carter got a perfect pass, and he scores, and the Kings lead 1-0.
Well, we talked about Voinov earlier, Bob. He's been so aggressive to start this game, and he's the man that ends up entering the zone offensively for the Kings. So the read is perfect. The neutral zone was real good. Maybe just you'll see the Kings get ready to break out. And as it happens, it's up the boards, and look at Voinov. He follows up. Richards is hit. But Voinov is right there. And you see Jeff Carter present his stick. Carter has his stick on the ice. See it right there? It's right there. It gives a target to Voinov. So the drive is there, but it's all about positioning. The 4-on-4 entry. Kings lead 1-0.
Carter gets his fifth of the year to lead the Kings in goal scoring. Candidate, and will be a great candidate, it looks like, for the Calder Trophy as Rookie of the Year.
The Blues were yelling, Bob, on that last entry. They expected an interference call against Ellerby.
Here's Carter cutting in front. Carter backhander. He scores! Jeff Carter down the right wing gives the Kings a 2-0 lead.
I was just mentioning, Bob, neutral zone speed by both teams. And it happened here, but this time the pass by Ellerby is absolutely perfect. Watch him get it over top of the stick, and the defenseman stands up, but he doesn't have support to the outside. Carter ends up scoring in a similar place. Watch, drag, and then back between. Get the goaltender to open up, but it's about that pass. Ellerby stood up. The Blues thought he got away with an interference, but when he got the puck on offense, that pass was floated over top of the defender right on the stick of Carter.
For Carter, his sixth goal in the last nine games. Across the line, Gawiski broke it up. Here's Lewis. Lewis at center. Lewis across the line with Carter. Lewis shoots. He scores! 49.6 seconds to go. It was deflected, but the Kings have the lead at 2-1.
Simple-looking play. Neutral zone, I'm not going to say turnover, but the Kings end up with speed the other way, and Lewis takes a shot. I believe Jeff Carter gets a stick on it. One of the few times the Kings have had center lane drive. So there it is in the neutral zone, as I mentioned, but the owners are going the wrong way without the puck. Three forwards get right by it. Shot. Yeah, I saw Carter kind of take a whack at it, and I believe he does knock it out of the air. Lewis doesn't think he has any help, but then he slows down to allow the help to catch up and get to him.
Richards on the loose puck. Drops it back to Carter with a drive, scores! Jeff Carter slams it home, and it's 3-1 LA.
Eighth goal of the year for Jeff Carter. I know I'm going to get an email from a respected hockey analyst right now calling Jeff Carter a one-trick pony, because I called Carter that last year and Bob McKenzie never lets me forget it. Jeff Carter releases the puck. It gets through Joey McDonald. Carter can shoot the puck. Apparently he can't catch it very well.
Again in the Avalanche zone, chased in by Trevor Lewis. Lewis behind the net to Richards. Richards got checked there, and coming by to take it away was Jan Heda, but he didn't clear. He got into the blue line and a shot wide to the left. Held in.
Stick there. That's all technique, all wrists, all arms, all everything from Jeff Carter. High slot.
Carter with his ninth of the year. Goals in three straight and five goals in his last six games. Oh, long pass into the King zone, played by Perry. He didn't get to it. Sent in front, tipped away by Doughty. Held in again by the Ducks. Doughty goes for it. His pass to Richards. Richards gets it out to center ice. Here's Carter with an empty net. Carter can put it away. He does! Jeff Carter with his 10th goal of the year and sixth goal in the last seven games into the empty net.
What a period by the LA Kings. And that's an understatement. Solid puck on the outside. Ducks pull the goaltender, really no chances. Richards here makes the veteran play, just getting it out. That's all he was trying to do, is get it out. Now it turns into a goal. He'll take it, Carter will take it. But the Kings preceding that, I know the Ducks had the puck in the zone.
Here's it behind the net to Brown. Kopitar. Richards, shot, and that's blocked by Cronwall. Back at the side of the net, they score!
Opens his stick up, Richard spots him and puts it exactly where he wants it, like a receiver and a quarterback hooking up, display the target, throw it towards there. Dustin Brown, they're worried about Dustin Brown in front. Jimmy Howard's concerned about him, and in comes Carter, who perfectly deflects it between the legs. And Carter continues his hot streak, 9 points in the last nine games, and ties the game up.
It took 2.5 periods, but the sellout crowd has something to be happy about as Jeff Carter scores his 11th goal of the year. It's a 5-on-3 goal, so the Kings are still on the power play.
Puck comes up the middle, held in by the Kings. Here's Voinoff at the right point. Voinoff feeds it down the right side. Now Voinoff again. His shot deflected up in the air and taken there by Stoll. Stoll's pass tipped away. Kings with it. Score! The puck came off the goaltender as Carter banked it off him into the net, and the Kings have a 1-0 lead.
Beautiful, crisp passing, one touch. No, I'm just kidding. I'm kidding. You just keep it in, you fight for loose pucks. I was just talking about earlier where the Kings were looking for someone else to do it. Here, it's a broken play. I believe Jeff Carter is trying to get this to Mike Richards. He keeps alive on the boards along with Stoll. Richards moves to the other side, and that's a pass. It shanks off his stick, goes between the legs of Rinne. It's one of those goals where the goaltender's anticipating the pass, and you can't blame him, but because of the shank, it goes in. Power play goal, it doesn't matter how, it's just how many. Kings lead 1-0.
Now across the line, Fraser's shot, blocked. He got knocked down, he got in front of Carter, he scores! Jeff Carter with his second of the game on a nice feed by Colin Fraser. And the Kings lead 2-0. And up to center ice, puck taken away. Here's Carter for the hat trick, and he scores! Jeff Carter with his third, and the Hats flood the ice at Staples Center. 3-0 Kings.
I think, Bob, a very attentive crowd here at Staples Center, because that's the fastest reaction I've ever seen. That puck wasn't in the back of the net, and there were hats on the ice. And Jeff Carter shows his patience here by can-opening the goaltender open. That's what he'll do to Rene here. And this ice is being littered.
Well, they were giving away Kings hats.
Yes, they were. And now they're giving them back. The stick check in the neutral zone would have been a penalty if not for the goal. Josi had it, and then Carter with a stick. But watch him. Little bit of a fake right there. He fakes it, open up, and then it's not a hard shot. It's more of just a scoop back. Look at Carter with a stick. Now Josi there as the last man back can't get picked. It's one of those things that you can't get picked. You saw how Carter just opened up his blade. That gives the indication as a right-hand shooter he might shoot. It's on his blade from this point on. It's open. It's open. Shoot. No, it's not. He goes with a deke between the pads. And very quickly, the Kings take a 3-0 lead. You know what he did there, Bob? It's very interesting. Jeff Carter not only opened up the goaltender, but he put a little elevation on the scoop to get it over the stick of Rinne.
The second guy is Bernie Nichols. He scored 70. The other guy, Patrick O'Neill, will have to tell you about that.
Kings win the draw. St. Louis zone. Here's Muzzin. He's got two tonight. Gives it to Carter. He shoots. He scores! And the Kings have the lead. Jeff Carter makes it 5-4.
And this comes off a face-off, Bob. I was just mentioning earlier how the Kings have been spending as much time as possible on face-off situations. And this one is a set play. Carter starts on one side, goes all the way to the other. Muzzin catches everyone, and the backhand pass here is important. Muzzin takes the backhand pass, and that saves time. Right there, he gets everyone leaning one way, and because he does not cross over to the forehand, he saves time with a backhand. Look at Jeff Carter. That's a goal scorer. He doesn't even look there. He just fires. And Yaroslav Halak is now on the bench, and Brian Elliott is in the game.
Well, they just had a tribute here to Stompin' Tom Connors, and his song, The Good Old Hockey Game, has been played in every arena around the NHL, and the fans were singing along tonight. He passed away the other day. So
His song lives among hockey fans everywhere.
Score by Carter. He banged it in. Jeff Carter gives the Kings a 2-1 lead. He's got 12 goals in the last 12 games.
Well, when you're hot, keep shooting. Daryl Sutter this morning at the morning skate said this about Jeff Carter. He is money, get him the puck. And this is one where the Kings did a good job again ahead of this. I know it's a fortunate bounce, but Dustin Penner held onto the puck. He used his body to shield it a couple of times. That line was very dangerous the last shift on the shorthanded situation. Carter gets the bounce off the skate of a defender. It ends up being one of those fortunate plays, but it started with a lot of hard work on the forecheck. You spend that time, but he is money right now for the Kings, and the Kings lead 2-1.
Right side, now over to Kopitar, back to Muzzin. Muzzin feeds it back on the right side, a shot, in a pass in front, and tipped and score. It was thrown by Lewis toward the front. Or Brown, I'm sorry, Brown toward the front and then deflected in. Jeff Carter getting his stick on it. And it's 1-0 Kings.
The passing is incredible. Watch this, fake shot pass across. I thought right here Brown's gonna score. He's gonna put it up, he doesn't. He goes across, and I believe it's Jeff Carter getting a piece. So you went one side, back, forth, the other. And when the goaltender sprawled, yeah, Carter's there. Jeff Carter has scored a lot of goals lately, 12 and 12 now, 13 and 13. I don't know if any of them would be easy. And just to make it look good, he taps it off the post there with a wide open net. That is supreme movement on the power play. Kings lead 1-0.
Carter gets knocked down, but the Kings get it back to center. Here on the right wing side, moving in, a shot from there, score! Down the right wing side. And the Kings now have a 4-0 lead.
Now it's back to back here. Jason LaBarbera is coming in. So back to back, Mike Smith certainly not looking good on the last two, but I'm gonna bail him out here. I didn't see it because that was going so fast. So I assume Mike Smith, I mean, he's trained to see these things, but this is the speed of Carter again. He just gets to top speed, head up, and then leans it out. I mean, that is a zinger. I mentioned the other night in San Jose with Dustin Brown with a laser. Well, this one is just as good, and it's hard, it's high, and it is right under the bar. It's a bad angle, so the goaltender says he should have it. Smith gets a rest, LaBarbera comes in.
King's trying to hold it in. Carter now gets his stick on it. Carter tied for fourth in goals in the NHL. Kings on the power play trying to take the lead. There's a shot and score by Carter from the right wing.
Wow.
Carter with a drive from the right wing, and he gets his 19th of the year to give the Kings the lead.
And Bob, it moves out of a tie, I believe, for fourth. At least coming in, as you were just saying that. And it's one of those where, and we went over it when we were back in Los Angeles. Carter gets some room here. But his ability to get power behind a shot is unprecedented on the Kings. And there's only a couple in the league. Look at net presence. Stoll is there, and Backstrom. Look, that's a great look, guys. Backstrom obviously can't see the puck. At the same time, the shot is absolutely perfect. I mean, it goes near post. It's high. It's hard. The screen's there. Another power play goal for the Kings.
Penner stays right with him. Now it's taken away by the Kings. Richardson. He gets it to Carter. Shot, score! Tipped in. In front was Penner. I don't know if it hit him, but Carter got the shot. And Jeff Carter is going to get his 20th goal of the season. And what a start for the Kings. They kept that line out there the whole time, and it pays off.
And they won those faceoffs, Bob. They kept winning them and then getting guys to the front. This one is Carter just backhanding it. There's Penner, first man on it. Richard just keeps it alive. Now watch this. He just gets there, he throws it. Now Penner is there. I don't think it hit Penner. I think it hit one of the Stars' defenders. We'll keep an eye right there. Dylan's there, number four. It looks like just a flutter ball. If anything, it's just kind of a backhand knuckleball. Look at Jeff Carter. He has a big smile on his face, so I guess exactly what you would want in any game, you get the first goal.
Now in deep, broken up there, just in the nick of time by the Kings. Drew Doughty, Kings again, pass in front, Carter scores! And the Kings have a 2-0 lead here in the first period.
When the Kings are coming up the ice, Bob, I'm thinking to myself, is Richards gonna see Carter? And I should stop thinking that because these guys have played together for so long. You'll see the Kings move out of the zone with pretty good speed. And keep an eye on the left side of the screen. There's the breakup. So Doughty breaks it up. Move the puck right side of your screen. See the change there by the Wild? Now watch this. Look at Carter. He's open. He's open. He's open. And Richards going one way, goes back against the flow. And Kings have a quick 2-0 lead. Now, the Wild are going to make a change of goal. You see, just holds on there. We've seen Jeff Carter score goals in so many different ways this year. We've seen him blow it by the goaltender. That time he just waited for Backstrom to open up. And now Darcy Kempler's gonna come and goal. Kempler's just gonna take over because Backstrom, the onslaught. I mean, you had the 2-on-1 with Williams, clear cut with Dustin Bowne. Then you have Mike Richards waiting for the perfect time.
Now Doughty moves over toward the left side. Kopitar down into Brown in front to Richards, he scores! Richards or Carter, they were both there. Take your pick, it's 2-0 Kings.
Shows you how much I know about hockey, Bob. I was just about to say the Kings look a little confused on this power play. They weren't really moving a lot, and the Oilers were smartly pressuring the puck a couple times. Give and go, but look at this. It's about bodies to the front. Carter's gonna get credit. It looks like Smithson, the new Oiler, coming over from Florida, former King, gets back and pressures. But the Kings just have too many bodies there. You have two big bodies. Richards, Carter off the leg, the side. There's no extension of the arm, so it's not batted in. It will end up into being a power play goal. It took time to set it up, but the Kings get a 2-0 lead.
Richardson again gives it to in front. Score by Carter. Nice pass by Richards to Carter, and he batted it out of midair. And the game is tied at 2-2. Carter getting the goal for the Kings, his 23rd of the year.
It's kind of fitting, at least from where I sit, that at least it would be tied after two because the Kings were controlling. Now, is this a set play? You know, Richards and Carter so many times, and Richards throws it about knee high. He probably knows that's the only way he can get it there. Is he making the assumption that Carter's gonna get a stick on it? Or is he just looking for a second chance? There's no second chance because Carter makes it happen. First opportunity. Carter takes a second whack, but by that time it's already in. Batting it out of midair. Goaltender can't be expected to find that one. Kings tied up 2-2.
Avalanche zone. Richards drops it back to Carter. Carter shoots, he scores! Jeff Carter with his 24th goal of the year. And the Kings lead 1-0. He maybe hasn't seen many shots like that in Finland.
I don't think so, Bob. No one can shoot the puck like Carter with a wrist shot. I mean, no one in the entire league. You'll see him here like high lie. He'll kind of scoop it. Watch this. Watch him change the angle. Out to in and flick it all in one motion. And then it's off the far post. It's high. It's perfectly placed. It's not a normal power play goal where you take time here to set it up. Now watch it. It comes from outside the dot. So you consider that a bad goal if you're a goaltender. But then you take into consideration who is shooting the puck. And Jeff Carter can get more on a wrist shot without a backswing than anyone I know. It works right there. Power play, Kings lead 1-0.
Taken there and cleared up to center ice. Kings take it away at the blue line. Muzzin at the King line.
Deserving of this, if it stands up. The only thing that would disallow it is a
Babette in with a hand by Carter. Fake shot, hold. Carter goes. It's thrown to the front. There's no bat there. No stick there. Whether it hit Carter or not, I think Carter, look, he's creating a screen now. I think it hit Jeff Carter.
They have not left the bench.
They have not, because they're reviewing this, and they review every goal.
Now the Kings have skaters out with flags indicating the Kings have won. But
I think it's going to count. It goes off the chest, not the arm, not the stick.
Here's the decision.
There it is.
It's
it
a
counts.
Good goal. Kings win.
They deserved it. I mean, the Kings.
He gives it back on the right side, and it rolls down in deep as it was pushed in by Voinov. Voinov playing in his 100th NHL game tonight. There's a shot. Carter with a score. It came right to Carter, and he wasted no time, and the Kings are on the board. It's 2-1 Minnesota, but Carter.
You're going to have to look at the clock, Bob. They're going to take a look to see whether it went in before. I think it did. I think it did, but of course, this is one of the reviewable situations. Wow, would this be important? How long has it been since the Kings have had a chance?
Yeah.
It's been a while, and then all of a sudden, yep. Burn the clock. That's going to count. Point eight. And Jeff Carter, much like the last game here, when he scored a goal that people were saying was teleported in, where no one saw it. Kopitar forecheck. Create the loose puck. Quick pass. Quick shot. And 0.8 seconds on the clock. Great job by the guys in the truck to get that clock there. Get it burned in. Kopitar will maybe not get an assist because I don't know if he touched it there, but he certainly created the turnover. And it's going to count. And the Kings are right back in this game. 22 shots for the Wild, 11 for the Kings. So they've doubled up, but they're doubling up on the board. But huge goal by Jeff Carter.
Kopitar already went to the dressing room. He's not going to wait 8/10 of a second to have him drop that puck.
That's right.
Carter with his 26th. That ties him for the third most goals in the league with John Tavares.